Hello, it's Keith here, and this is lesson 30 of the platform-specific series of my 65 auto-assembly programming tutorials. Now, we looked at the VIC-20 last time, and this time we're going to look at the Commodore 64. Now, the Commodore 64 and the VIC-20 have some commonalities, but the sound is very, very different. Now, the Commodore 64 uses the SID sound chip, which is very famous, and it's got a very distinctive tone that a lot of people absolutely love. It's certainly a very powerful sound chip, and we're going to be looking at it today. Now, like with the VIC-20, the SID uses memory address ports at D400 to D41C. Now, effectively, we have three voices, but each one of these is capable of a wide variety of things. It can do different sound effects, it can do noise, it can set a large range of pitches, and you've got sustain and release options. So they're all effectively equal, unlike with the VIC-20, where each channel did a very different thing, and they really couldn't share. And they really couldn't do the same thing as each other. This is totally different this time. They can all do the exact same functionality as each other. So we're going to do the same as last time, if you didn't catch it. What we do on all of our tutorials is we create a little driver called Chibi Sound. Chibi Sound takes a single byte. It's designed for simple sound effects. It takes 6 bits, which define a pitch. It takes 1 bit, which defines a low or high volume. And it takes 1 bit for the tone, which is either something resembling a square wave or some kind of noise distortion effect, and the pitch will change accordingly. So let's hear Chibi Sound on the Commodore 64. So here you can hear the tone, it's getting higher as the number is decreasing. And when the bit 6 goes to 0, then it becomes quieter but starts increasing again. And as we go below 0, you're going to hear it turn to noise. Yeah. So Chibi Sound is a very crude driver. It works as a nice little example, but if you're creating a multi-platform game and you need to have some sound effects on all of them, it allows you to do little bleeps and explosion effects, which is what it did in Grime 6502, Grime Z80, and Grime 68000. So let's have a look at the code of Chibi Sound and see how it works on the Commodore 64. So here it is. It's pretty straightforward. So the first thing we're going to be doing is we're going to be defining the pitch. As I said, all of these channels are completely equal. They can all do tones, they can all do noise. So we're going to be using voice 1 in all cases. So it doesn't matter whether we're creating noise or whether we're creating tones, we're always going to use channel 1. And that's certainly not the case of a lot of systems. With the VIC-20, for example, we had to write to a different port depending on whether we were making a tone or a noise. So first what we're doing here is we're selecting these 6 bits here. We're flipping them over just because we need the tone to go in the same direction on all systems. And then we're just storing that to D401. Now, the tone is actually made up of 2 registers, but we've only got 6 bits of definition and this takes 16. So we don't have enough to set the low tone at all. So we're just leaving that. So we are taking the 6 bits we've got, we're storing them in D401 here, and that will set the tone's pitch. Now, next what we're going to do is we're going to check the noise bit. This is the top bit here. And if the noise bit isn't 0, we're going to jump to here. Now, if the noise bit is 0, we're going to load the accumulator with 0, 1 and then 6 zeros here. When we get to this point, we're then going to set the bottom bit to 1. Well, why are we doing this? Well, we're going to write to D404 here. Now, the top bit here defines where the noise is on. The next bit defines whether we're going to make a tone. So we're going to use this pulse option here. That's the kind of tone we're going to make. But also we need to set bit 0 here to 1 to turn the channel on. So we're setting bit 0 to 1 here, and that's turning the channel on. If we're jumping at this point, we're making a noise. Now, coincidentally, the top bit here and the top bit here both define the noise, which is why we're jumping if that's non-zero. If the top bit was 0, though, we want to make a tone. So we need to set this bit, which we're doing just here. So either way, this will effectively set either the noise or the tone for channel 1. Now we're going to set some default values here. We're going to load the X register with 0. We're going to set the pulse width low to 0 here in D402. We're going to set the attack and decay to 0 as well. Now these are how the tone builds up and fades away. We want it to be a very simple flat tone, so we're just setting all of that to 0. We're then decrementing X, which turns it to 255. We're then setting the low bits of the frequency, because remember we didn't have enough bits for the frequency before, so we're just defining the rest as 1. We're then setting the pulse width high. We're only setting 1 nibble effectively there, but that doesn't matter that we've set all of the bits to 1. and we're setting the sustain and release. Again, this is how the tone is held and how it's released as the tone stops. So we're just setting again all of these to some nice simple values to make a constant tone. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is set the volume bit. Remember, we have just a single bit of volume in our tubi sound definition. So we get that. We then shift it to the right, effectively moving to this position here, set the other bits to 1, and then we store that into D418, which we saw before when we branched here via tubi sound to turn the sound off. And this effectively sets the volume. We're not using any of these advanced filters, so just an easy way of setting the volume there and making a nice simple sound. Now, obviously, I've only covered some very simple stuff here. There's a lot more that the SID chip can do. One thing we can do for a bit of fun, if I just play this again here. Now, you can see here this is the default tone, but if I just close that, and then if I change, this value, and if I just put in a pair of zeros here and compile this again. We can hear we've got a very different tone now. So it's really easy to just change the kind of sound that's being made if that's what we want. So of course you can play with the other options here. I'm hoping that this is going to be just a simple starting point for you to build better things. We've only used channel 1 here. You could use all 3 channels in the same way, and you could use the effects and filters. But as I say, I just wanted to give you enough to get you started to make something of your own. Anyway, that's all we're going to be covering today. I hope you'll join me next time because we're going to be doing another system. Thanks for watching anyway, and goodbye. Now, if you have questions, comments, or suggestions, please feel free to sign up to my web forums. Every tutorial episode has its own section on the forum. If you just click on these buttons here, you'll see it goes to a matching page of my forum. The forum's just at chibiacamas.com/forum. It's free to sign up, of course. You can show off your project you're working on. I totally encourage you to show us what you're working on. And if you've got any questions, any suggestions, please let me know them. It's purely an assembly forum. So if you're working on assembly programs and you want to show them off, please sign up and show us what you're working on. Thanks a lot.